Hello and welcome to Java Fundamentals. My name is Matt Greencroft and I've been programming in a number of languages for about 20 years and Java in particular for the last 3 or 4. I've designed this course to be a comprehensive introduction to the key topics in Java. If you are wanting to learn Spring, Java Web Development, or any other more advanced Java topic, this course is going to be a really good starting point. I'm assuming that you're coming to this course with some programming experience in any language. I'm not covering the core fundamentals of programming here, but I am going to show you how you do them in Java. What this means is that if, for example, you don't know what a loop or a condition means, you'll be able to do this course, but you might want to look up these terms for some extra clarity. I have written this course completely from scratch. I've worked really hard to ensure that what we cover is going to be the kind of code you would be writing on real-world production-quality projects. In fact, throughout this course, we're going to be working on a real-world example application. I am not going to be talking about abstract concepts. All the examples will relate to the application we are going to be building. And you'll be able to reuse lots of the code that we write in your own applications. In this course, you won't be listening to hours of lectures, but instead you'll be writing with me lots of production quality code. Our style is based on virtual pair programming. You will be actively programming throughout the course, and in fact, that's the best way to learn. I want you to imagine that I am sat next to you, and you can look at my screen at any point, but you're following along and recreating everything I'm doing in your own development environment. I'll be taking you through every step along the way, including installing the software you need to be building applications in Java. All you need to run this course is going to be a working computer running either Microsoft Windows, Mac OS, or some variant of Linux or Unix. If you are using the download version of this course from our website, make sure you have downloaded the practicals and code files. These contain sample code which you can refer to throughout the course, some instructions for practical exercises, and even some of the software that you'll need as we progress. If you're using the DVD version, you'll find the practicals and code folder on the DVD. I want to make sure that you get through the Java Fundamentals course successfully, and that you pick up marketable skills along the way. If you get stuck, then first check the sample code provided in the practicals and code folders, and see if you can work your own way out of the problem. But don't stay stuck for days. You can always contact us using the link on our webpage. We can only really help you with the course topics. I'm afraid we can't help you design your own applications or fix problems in your own projects, but for anything relating to the course materials, our support team will be happy to help. We try and respond to all requests for help within 2 working days, although it's always worth checking the errata which we publish on our website, where we will list any known problems. You'll also find on our website links to blog posts, which give extra information about some of the topics on this course. I'm going to now run through the key topics we'll be covering on this course, and then I'll tell you about the project that we'll be building together. We start in Chapter 2, where we will install Java. We will work in a simple text editor just to get started. But in Chapter 3, we'll install a development environment used by most Java professionals. In Chapter 4, we'll start coding. We'll look at Java variables. And in Chapter 5, we'll move on to control flow. In 6, we'll look at how to compare strings. And by Chapter 7, we'll start to get more serious and we'll introduce object orientation. In Chapters 8 and 9, we'll start the foundations of our real-life project. Chapter 10 introduces arrays of objects. In Chapter 11, we'll structure our project professionally using packages. And in Chapter 12, we'll move on to look at the Java library. We'll continue exploring the Java library in Chapter 13, which is dedicated to handling numbers, Although what we're really going to do in this chapter is show you how to use the Java Help system. In chapter 14, we look at how to handle garbage in Java. Chapter 15 covers inheritance, and we now start to get more advanced. Chapter 16 covers overriding, and chapter 17 looks at how to correctly implement equals and toString. Good Java programmers will always do this. Chapter 18 is all about exceptions, and by chapter 19, it will be time to put a lot of what we've been learning into practice. We'll do a practical session at this point. In chapter 20, it's time for unit testing, and chapters 21 and 22 cover the topic of collections. Then in chapter 23, it'll be polymorphism, and in 24, we'll look at Java interfaces. These aren't graphical interfaces, it's a programming concept. Chapters 25 and 26 will explain how to work with databases in Java using a library called JDBC. And in chapter 27, we'll put it all together with a major practical session. We'll finish the course with chapter 28, how to deploy your application, and we'll use an external library in this chapter. Chapter 29 will be a review of the course, and in this chapter, I'll show you the best books to use and where to go next in Java. So before we start, I'd like to talk to you about the project that we'll be working on together. The practical I have chosen is going to cover the operations of a lending library. So we'll be creating code that allows us to manage customers, things that can be lent to customers, such as books and DVDs, and our code will manage the lending process. So that's a brief overview of our project. We'll be starting work on that in Chapter 8, but let's start first with the basics and installing Java for the first time. I'll see you to do that in Chapter 2.